friends, this is Pavani. I'm going to explain Excel. I have 10 years of experience. Now we can see how to open Excel. So if you want to open Excel, just we can use in a shortcut form. Just press Windows plus R in your keyboard and type EXCEL, not MS Excel. Just type EXCEL and press enter button in your keyboard. Excel will be opened here. Here we can select, just select blank workbook. Okay, just select blank workbook. The sheet will be opened. And here we can see Excel is based on rows and columns. Okay, Excel is based on rows and columns. And here at the top of the document, it is known as title bar. Whatever the name you have saved for Excel, it will be appeared at the top of the document. After that, these known as customized quick access toolbar. This is known as customized quick access toolbar. Under customized quick access toolbar, we can see menu bars. Menu bars means file, home, and insert, page layout, formulas, data, review, view. These all are known as menu bars. Under menu bars, whatever the option you are selecting, for example, if I am selecting insert menu bar, under insert menu bar, we will see the different types of options. Okay, these options known as ribbons. Whatever menu bar you select, for example, page layout, under page layout, we see different types of options that all are known as ribbons. Okay, under menu bars, we will select the options that all are ribbons. After this, we can see here name box. Name box means, for example, if you are placing the cursor here. Now, I want to know where my cursor has been placed. So, if you want to know that, for example, here I will check here in M column and 16th row. Okay, so if you want to go through directly, we can see in name box M16 I have placed my cursor. For example, here I am placing. So I want to know that. So if you want to know, just select, see here T23. Your cursor has been placed in T23 cell. Okay. And next F of X means formula bar. For example, if you are writing any matter on any information, if you are writing in a particular cell, that will appear in F of X means formula bar. See here, I am writing here, for example, here employees. Okay, here I want to edit this. If you want to edit, just press F2. Okay, F2, employee data, like this. Okay, I want to write any matter in that particular cell, or else if you want to edit or delete, we can just select near particular cell and press F2. You can edit or you can modify whatever it may be, you can do with the help of F of X. Okay, and next here we can see in at the bottom of your Excel, we can see here zoom in, zoom out. See here, here it is zoom in and zoom out. See, okay, zoom in and zoom out it is. And we have a different page layouts here. If you want page layout here, this is the page layout, means it will be different. This is one page and this is next page. And next here, page 1, page 2, we'll drag it. See, this is page 1, page 2, page 3, page 4. Okay, if you want to normal view, just select here normal. Okay, and here I want to go to next sheet. For example, Excel is nothing but like a book. In book we have different pages, like that. In Excel also, if you want to move to different sheets, just place your cursor near plus symbol and select here new sheet. How many sheets you want to select, just select here sheet 1, sheet 2, sheet 3, sheet 4, sheet 5, like that. We can select more sheets in an Excel, that is the one book. Total sheets are included in a one book. Okay, here. And if you want to name the sheets, means if you want to, for example, this is the employees data, right? So I want to name the sheet 1, 2 as a employee. Just place the cursor here and select right click, okay, and rename it. Rename and write here employees sheet, like that. Employee sheet, if you want to write it, just employee data. Okay, this is in right click here. Okay, if you want to colors, tap color like this. Here we can do it. If you want to protect is not one. If you want to give to your sheet any security or password, we can do here. For example, I want to lock this sheet, only I want to open that sheet, not by anyone. Okay, so just place your cursor here, just right click, and here protect sheet. I want to give the password ABC. Okay, okay, and re-enter. Okay, okay, now I am sheet 3. I want to open the employee data. Here I am selecting, I want to write it. See, the cell or chart you are trying to change is on a protected sheet, means whatever the data you want to write in employee data, that sheet has been occurred with password. Okay, if you type that password, only the sheet will be opened. Okay, just place your cursor on OK button. Okay, if you want to open, to make changes, click unprotect sheet in the review tab. Right click, unprotect sheet. It will ask the password. So if you remind the password, just type here ABC. Click on OK. We can edit it. Understood? We can see once more. For example, I want to protect one sheet. Means I want to give the password to one sheet. That is personal sheet. Okay. This is a student data. Student data. I want to rename this. Just right click here. And here rename it attendance. Okay, I want to protect this sheet. See, now if I want to write any data here, I can write it. So if you don't want to see by anyone, I want to password, I want to give the password to this, just right click here and select here protect sheet. Whatever the password you want to apply, just apply there. 1 2 3 4. Okay. Okay, repeat the password 1 2 3 4. Okay, and here attendance. I'm going to attendance. I want to edit this, means I want to write the student attendance or present, absent, whatever it may be. Just I want to type. See, to make changes, click unprotect sheet in the review tab. Means the sheet is, the sheet, if you want to unlock, you want to give the password. Okay, it is in lock. Just place the cursor there, press right click, unprotect sheet, give the password what you have been given, 1 2 3 4. Just okay. Okay, and here we can edit it. Here we can edit. So this is the protected sheet. Each sheet, if you want to give, for each sheet, whatever the sheets you want to give, you can select and give the password for that particular sheet. Now coming to the matter, here just basics we can know. Here we can take one new sheet. See, now first you want to prepare any tables, or if you want to write any products or else employee data, rule numbers, whatever it may be. If you want to mention, for example, one, next cell I want to write here 2. Next, continuously I want to write till 100. So 1, 2, 3, 4, you can't go through like this 100, no. Just if you want to write directly, just write here 1 and 2. Just select these first two cells and place your cursor near edge. Okay, till where you want the numbers, maybe till 30, 50 or whatever. If you want to till 1000, we can do it, go through 1000 also. Just place the cursor there, click it. Okay, double click. Okay, just select it. Let's see, here we can see the edge here. Okay, whenever the plus symbol will be occurred, just double click and drag it. Just double click, just place the cursor and click and drag it here till I can select till 444. I need 400 numbers like this. Once again, we can see here the number. If you want till 110, just place the cursor in any cell 1, okay, and 2. I want to write till 53. I can't go through 1, 2, 3, 4, right? Just place the 1, 2, okay. Just select it and place the cursor near edge. Click and drag it till where you want, there, like this, 26. Okay. For example, if you want even numbers, okay, even numbers, if you want to mention same like 2, 4, 6 till 50, if you want, same process. So just write here 2 and next 4. Okay. Select it, place the cursor near edge, click and drag. Okay. Like this. Same. For example, after, from 6 I need. So if you want from 6, then 6. Next to even number 8. Okay. Select it. Place the cursor and drag it. Like this. Okay. It depends upon the cells. First two cells or as first cell. For example, if you need odd numbers. See, I want to write here 1. And next I want to write here 3. Okay. Just select it, click and drag it like this. Understood? Here, depends upon the first two cells. For example, if you are giving any numbers in the first cell, 4, if you are giving, once you click and drag it, what will happen here? It will appear only one number. Okay, depends upon the cells what you are given. Maybe if you are given serial numbers, even or single number or odd numbers, it will get the next output. Okay, with the help of the first two cells or first cell. So these are the numbers which you want to write in your Excel. Okay. And next, here we can see if you want to write in weekdays or else monthly. Weekdays or monthly days, if you want to write. For example, I'm writing here Monday. Until next Sunday I want to mention. Okay. Just select it, click and drag it. Here we can see. See here, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, the days we can see here. Same like month also. January, if you want to write here, January. Okay. Just select, click and drag like this. Same numbers based on the cells. And Monday, Tuesday, if you want to write, we can do this. And here also we can do till months if you want to write. Here also we can do the months. So these are the some basics of Excel. If you want to know, just it will be possible with this. Okay. So what we have learned, just if you want to write numbers, just select the first two cells, click and drag it. Or else even numbers if you want to write, just even numbers, odd numbers, odd numbers. And different sheets if you want to make, what we want to press, just select plus symbol in your sheet. Okay. And if you want to protect your sheet, if you want to protect your sheet, what we should do? Place whatever the sheet you want to protect, just select the sheet, okay? And select here, place your cursor near sheet and press right click, okay? We can protect sheet, okay? The protect sheet, give the password and re-enter the password and leave it. Again, if you want to open, just unprotect the sheet. So that is the some basics, okay. And now here we can see different rows and columns. Here alphabets we can see here, A, B, C, D. These are the columns, A, B, C. These are the columns and these are the rows, okay. Here, so you can see here, rows. If you want to insert the columns or if you want to insert the rows, we can do that. So for example, I want to insert here. If you want to do, just place your cursor here, right click, insert. Here we can be insert. If you want to delete, just same, select it, delete like this. If you want to insert, we can insert. If you want to delete, we can delete it. Okay. Same in columns also. If you want to insert, just insert it. Okay, D. How many columns if you want to insert, we can insert that many columns. if you want to delete, I am deleting this column. For example, here I have written this 1, 2, 3. I want to delete this column. So if you want to delete that, place the cursor here and select right click. Here we can delete. Same. I want to delete this. Delete. Okay. This one also I want to delete. Delete. Want to hide. Hide, unhide. Okay. This K column I want to hide. Okay. So if you want to hide that, place the cursor here itself and select, right click, hide it. See, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J and L. There is no K column. Where it is, it has been hided. Okay. And here, for example, these 16, I want to hide it. Just right click, hide it. Okay, we can't see this 16. After 15, we can see 17. After J, we can see L. So like this, if you want to hide, unhide or insert, delete, we can do in the Excel. So you want to insert, means unhide that. Just select it, unhide. Okay, and here also. Unhide it. So this is just select it, delete it, delete. Okay. And here, after opening your sheet, you have written and you want to save this. So if you want to save, what is the shortcut key to save your Excel? Just Ctrl plus S. Here, if you select Ctrl plus S, we can save it. Okay. If you want to save in desktop or else documents, whatever, you can save it. I want to save in desktop. It is in book 1. I want to rename it. So if you want to the data of students, okay, save it. Well, the name we have given, data of students. See, at the top we can see here data of students. Before that we can see the book 1. Okay, if you give the title name, whatever the title name you have given, it will be displaying on the top of the document. We have given data of students. Okay. And here, coming to the first file. In file, we can see so many options here. Info, new, open, save. Okay. Save as, print, share, export, close. All these we can see the options here. Okay. It is nothing. If you want to, these are the simple options. In file, we all know whatever the options will be here. Okay, new means if you want to open one more document, okay, we can open here like this. In the shortcut key, if you want to open, just press Ctrl plus N. Okay, Ctrl plus N if you want to open the next Excel. Ctrl plus N here. Okay. And this is the open. Open means the previous whatever the data you have be done in your Excel if you want to open. For example, I have opened book 2. I want to go to data. If you want to, means students data Excel I want to open. So if you want to open, what we should do? Just press Ctrl plus O. If we will press Ctrl plus O, we can see here data of students. Date sheet will be open, right? So this is the shortcut key. If you want to open new sheet, what we need to select? Ctrl plus N, and before previous, if you want to open, Ctrl plus O. Okay, MS Excel if you want to open new, Ctrl plus N and O for Ctrl plus open. Here we can see different options. And save means whatever the options you are, whatever the data you are entering in your sheet Excel, if you want to save it, okay, if you want to save, that is nothing but save. Save as means here we can select here. See, data of students, save as like this. As if you want to save as PDF mode or Excel template, web page, XML data, this is the save as. Okay, save as is different. Okay, in this, if you want to save, you can say, if you want to save through PDF mode, if you want to Excel, XML, like this, wait, XML data. If you want to save to that, we can save it. Okay, here. And print. If you want to give a print, we can see here. Microsoft print to PDF, okay, XPS document, like this if you want to do it, collated, 1, 2, 3, like this. For example, I want to get a print. See here, we have not written any data. For example, we have done here, any data here, 1, 2, select it, click and drag, okay. Click and drag it. So print if you want to give it. Just go to file, select print here. Here we can do it. Collected if you want, collected. A4 size if you want to give in A4 size. Okay, here. Depends upon our selection, the paper will be changed like this. See here. The numbers we have written, no? Like this. Normal margins or arrow margins, we can select here. See. Wide. This is in wide. Narrow. Okay? Depends upon our selection, print can be selected. Okay. Export. Export and save as is nothing. If you want to convert to PDF mode or as XPS document, it can be converted. So if you want to close, it will be closed here. Do you want to save? It means we can save, or else don't save, or else cancel. Okay. This is the some basics of your Excel here. So that's simple. The numbers, if you want to mention even numbers, or else if you want to open the new sheets like this, all we can see in our Excels. Okay. Thank you, and we can see next topic. Thank you all.